So we've talked about why we have children go out. We've talked about the things adults have to think about and plan in terms of the sort of infrastructure available for the going out. We've talked about all the practical things the children need to consider as they're planning going out. But there's actually still more. There's still more to think about. And this is really supporting the children in some of the little aspects that will help them throughout the outing. You know, for example, we need to educate them about some of the grace and courtesies that exist out in society. So, you know, we need to help them understand if they're going to the downtown of a busy city, how you walk on a crowded sidewalk. First time I took a group to downtown Seattle, there were about four or five of them, and they just walked, you know, four or five abreast across the sidewalk, you know, running into people and, you know, not, they, you know, they didn't think of it ahead of time that when there's a crowded street, we maybe walk two by two or that sort of thing. So you want to consider any little presentations or guidance you want to give them on that, or even practice that you want to do before they leave. The same is true for riding public transportation. So here in the Washington, D.C. area, on an escalator down to the subway, you stand on the right side of the escalator, but not on the left. You leave that open for people who want to walk down the escalator, and you'll get bumped into if you don't follow that sort of tradition here in the area. So any sort of guidance that you can give them about how they take their public transportation or how they work, you know, walk through their city or anything else that's, you know, particular to your area, you'll need to do a little presentation or have a little conversation about, and sometimes have some practice with before they go out. Also, we want to help the children be prepared of what to do in case there's an emergency on the trip. You know, this is a balance of, you know, we don't want to scare them, but we also want them to have some common sense about how to handle an emergency. You know, what happens if you get separated from your group? Whether this is if it's in a, you know, a museum, you know, we want the children to stay where they are. Someone is going to notice you're missing and come find you. So it's hard to find you if you keep moving. So stay put. If it's on a subway, then, you know, that you want the children to know, get off at the next stop. And, you know, if the child stays on the train and you all have gotten off, tell the child to get off at the next stop and wait. We'll come and get you. Any sorts of preparations you can have for, you know, some common mistakes and minor emergencies that might occur. That's the kind of preparation you want to give the children so that they're able to handle, you know, some of these situations that can emerge. We also want to talk through sort of the general expectations of behavior at these different venues that they might be visiting. So, you know, we want them to understand that when you go to a museum, we tend to talk in a little bit of a quieter voice so that we don't distract the others around us. I always warn children, too, that museums often, the security people in different rooms don't tend to trust children. And so they might get very nervous when children approach a piece of art or get too close to something. So that's something for the children to be conscious of, just that there are a lot of children that are less respectful than most of our children usually are. So I encourage them to approach a piece of artwork or something slowly and not be offended if an adult has a bit of an overreaction at times. We want to guide them if we're taking a tour in how you listen to someone who's speaking to you on a tour and how you wait for an appropriate time to ask questions. You know, you want to guide them through how they, you know, swipe their Metro card or how the bus takes the ticket or any of those other little minor, you know, procedures that are often peculiar and particular to each individual locale. So those are some other sorts of practical things to support the children with preparing for before they go out. oftentimes for children on a going out, this is maybe the first time that they have had to pay admission themselves to a site, that they've walked up and handled the money or handled the bank card or whatever you're using. That may be the first time they've done that. So it might be useful to do some preparation on how that happens. We can't, you know, even though children have been with their parents or other adults, you know, at stores and other places, we can't assume that they have taken in some of the process of how this works. And it can make them really nervous. I have remember clearly where I had a group of children at the grocery store, and we actually went over budget on, you know, so the children had, I don't know, a $20 bill, and it was something like $21. So they had to do some thinking in line, and they were so panicked and worried and dropping the money and all of those things, you know. So we want to help them, you know. Some of that's going to happen no matter what, but if we can do some preparation ahead of time to help them have some experience or be prepared for some of these things that could occur, it's just going to make it that much easier for them when they encounter some of these situations. So beyond the sort of practical logistics of preparing for going out, think through some of these other things that the children might encounter, and think of ways that you can offer them a little lesson to help them feel more prepared for that. Or alternatively, if you are the one on the outing with them, you can, you know, take some of these opportunities to turn them into spontaneous lessons on the trip as well. So the children will have to be, you know, there's a lot for them to manage. This is a big endeavor. So any little bit of preparation we can do to support them ahead of time is going to help them.